from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. A hot button issue is in front of Portland residents tonight. City Council will hear the pros and cons of a proposal to ban weapons in public places statewide. The chair of Portland's Public Safety Committee and counselor, Dan Skolnick, introduced the idea. He wants to draft a resolution to the full council to ask the state legislature to ban guns in certain public places. In Portland, that would include venues like Fitzpatrick Stadium, the Expo, and City Hall. The ban makes limited exceptions for certain groups with concealed weapons permits, like law enforcement.
You're taking an individual right away from citizens. You're making their life that much harder if they want to take an active role in the self-defense of their personal selves.
I believe we can find a solution that does not impact the ability to protect oneself, even in a public facility.
Shane Bellinger says there may be no need for the second meeting. Bellinger and a few other critics of the ban say they think the idea will die on the table tonight. While former Arundel selectman and his girlfriend charged with drug trafficking and selling stolen goods made their initial appearance in York County Court this morning. Byron Kinley and Tina Gagne did not enter pleas during their appearance in Alfred. Just last month, Kinley resigned his position with the town of Arundel. Police arrested the two back in June during a raid on the gas station, which Kinley owns, located on Route 111 in Arundel. All the charges come from what investigators call a fencing operation, where thieves would bring stolen goods to Kinley's gas station in exchange for cash or Vicodin pills. The couple will be back in court in December. Members of the New Hampshire and Maine congressional delegations are appealing to federal officials when it comes to getting help for the failing Memorial Bridge. Senators Olympia Snowe and Susan Collins, along with Congresswoman Shelley Pingree, wrote a letter urging the U.S. Transportation Secretary to support efforts to win federal grants to help replace the bridge that links Portsmouth and Kittery. The letter says the bridge replacement project would create 197 on-site jobs and 950 indirect jobs. Officials in the two states are trying to decide what to do about the deteriorating 80-year-old Memorial Bridge. Replacing it would cost an estimated $87 million. A camper rollover on the turnpike just outside of Portland snarled traffic for a while this morning. State police say a truck towing a camper rolled over in the northbound lane of the turnpike near mile marker 49. The accident happened just before 8 this morning between the Westbrook and Falmouth exits. It took police a couple of hours to get things cleaned up and reopened again, and there are no reports of anyone getting hurt, which is good. Well, thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.